This is Match Game 74, production number 0231, and it is take one. Get ready to match the stars. Jack Nahr. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Elaine Joyce. Richard Dawson. And Fanny Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. To Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
That's Johnny Olson. Thank you for joining us here. Hello, ladies. How's everybody? Everybody okay?
Listen,
Fanny.
Yes. What?
Would you stand up so everybody can see it? Fanny, let's see it. Listen, I've known Fanny for a long time, and all I can say is it's a lie.
But, Gene, I ordered scrambled.
Oh, I see. Well, I think we ought to welcome the new kid on the block.
Yeah, let's check it out.
Jack
Nahr. Thank
you, Gene. Yeah.
Hot seat. So you've been...
Jack.
Great show.
Yeah, he has a marvelous show.
Good show.
Yeah. You ever see his show?
Every morning.
Now you see it.
Yeah. Right on. See, you're still stealing glasses off the airplane, huh, Gene?
No, this is a little hangover from
From a bottle of vodka.
Yeah. No. Well, listen, shall we say hello to our two players?
Oh, yes.
Why?
All right.
They are Teresa Negrete and Rolanda Lallier. Hello, ladies.
Hey.
Are you ready? Teresa's a current champ with $600 to her credit. She's won one game. And we're in the middle of round one. Is that right, ladies? Now, you've had your question, and you didn't score, did you? No. And we're about to have your question. Is that right?
Yes.
Okay, we'll get to that right after we do this for you, especially. Here we go. There. We're just talking to the audience, and I'll push the button and reveal this first round question for Teresa. You ready?
Yes.
All right. Everyone listen carefully. Everybody plays. Hey, here's something for you.
Oh, what?
How to streak.
Woo-hoo.
One, take off your clothes.
Woo.
Two, run as fast as you can. Three, look out for blanks.
Again.
One, take off your clothes. Two, run as fast as you can. Three, look out for blanks.
Woo.
Did you hear that, Teresa?
Yes.
All right, think about it. While they're writing their answer. Now, have you all got your clothes off?
Oh, heavens.
All right, I know something you don't know. Okay, Teresa, how to streak. One, take off your clothes. Two, run as fast as you can. Three, look out for blanks. What do
Dogs.
You put in the blank?
What?
Dogs.
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 Look out for dogs.
Bow wows.
Yeah, bow wows is what she said, right. Jack, what did you say?
Well, I based mine on personal experience because I streaked once and I was arrested for littering. So I said, watch out for the law.
The law. Yeah. Look out for the law. Okay, Brett?
Well, I figure if you're streaking, there's nothing further to tear off your body, right?
Yeah?
So I said the cops or the fuzz or a policeman.
I see, okay.
Yeah, don't be behavioral.
Look out for cops, Charles.
There's cops around the other corner, too.
Right. That seems to be the answer, Teresa, and she's looking for dogs. What do you say?
I say if you're streaking and you're running around, watch out for drafts.
Naturally. Ooh, it gets very
especially
cold out
here.
There. Would you like my... Oh, no, all right. What would you do there?
Well, I did streak, and like Jack, I also was arrested. I was released because of insufficient evidence.
Cops. Is he too much?
I put stairs.
Look out for stairs.
Honey, have you ever tried to run up stairs?
Well, yes, okay. Yeah. All right, so there was no match there, and so at the end of round one, we have no score, and we go to round two and ask Rolanda to make a choice.
B, please.
B is what you want. Okay, Rolanda, here we go. Everybody plays, because no one matched. On the battleship, one sailor said to another, I'm worried about the captain. Here we are in the middle of a battle, and he's blanking off the starboard bow. I have to do it for Rolanda.
Oh, all right, okay.
Because her command of the English language is a little incomplete, and I want to make sure she has every opportunity to hear it. On the battleship, one sailor said to another, I'm worried about the captain. Here we are in the middle of a battle, and he's blanking off the starboard bow. What is that? She doesn't understand a darn word I said.
She's not alone.
You know what the starboard... You know what the bow of a ship is? That's the front of a ship. You know what a ship is?
Yes.
Yeah, it's a thing that goes on the water.
I came on a ship.
Yeah, and so you came on a ship. Oh, really? And you know what starboard is? It's, starboard is right and port is left. That's sailors talk that way. Well, what do they know?
They never talk that way to me.
Starboard means the captain was standing. Well, it's time for give us an answer, Rolanda. I'll give it to you one more time. On the battleship, one sailor said to another, I'm worried about the captain. Here we are in the middle of a battle, and he's blanking off the starboard bow.
Kissing.
Kissing?
Yeah.
Kissing. Well, I guess she understands sailors better than I thought she did. So...
Kissing?
What do you say?
He said kissing.
Yeah, she said kissing. What do you think about the
captain,
Jack?
Well, I had him in another mood. Yeah. Other than that, I had him scared to death. Yeah. I had him barfing.
Oh, I see. Okay. Brett, what do you say?
Well, my sailor captain was very proper, and in spite of everything, he was saluting.
Saluting. Off the starboard bow. Okay. Charles, you understand sailors, do you?
I'm sorry, I didn't put kissing. I put fishing.
Fishing. Very good, Charles. That's a good answer. It really is. Excellent answer. What do you say, my dear?
It was marlin season, and he was fishing.
It was fishing, yeah. You got the good one there. Dawson, what do you say?
I say let's go somewhere where we're not known.
Start all over again. Oh,
okay.
I said the captain was dancing.
Oh, really? Well, let's close the kissing.
Time just flew away.
Maybe later they did some kissing. Fanny, what was this captain doing off the starboard bow?
Well, he was a real chicken. I said he was jumping.
Jumping?
Wouldn't you? I don't want to get shot.
Well, Rolanda, that's nothing for you, and we've got a question for you, and all you're going to do is to have match one celebrity, you'll win another game. Teresa, we'll get to that, but first this, and then come back. All right, we're in the middle of our second and final round. Rolanda did not score in that last round. She had a little bit of tough luck there, and we'll see how Teresa does. Teresa, all you need is one match to win your second game. This is it, folks. Bernard said, I don't know about Pierre, my new hairdresser. He does a terrific job, but he sure blanks funny. Bernard said that. Did you hear that? Bernard said, I don't know about Pierre, my new hairdresser. He does a terrific job, but he sure blanks funny.
I love the way Charles always nods off between the time you finish the question and the time he does his answer. He takes these little cat naps. And he's not wearing any socks.
Again.
Again.
Yeah. Guard!
All right. All set, Teresa. Bernard said, I don't know about Pierre, my new hairdresser. He does a terrific job, but he sure blanks funny.
Kisses funny.
He kisses funny.
Kiss, kiss, kiss.
You don't like that answer? You don't think anybody here said kisses. Is that what you're saying, audience? No? You don't know these weirdos. Jack, did you say kissing?
No, I did not.
You did not? What did you say?
I wouldn't say such a thing. This is always, this would precede it, though. He talks funny.
He talks funny.
He walked like a human and he talked like a human, but he crawled on his belly like a reptile. He talks funny.
Talks funny. One kiss wins the game. One kiss, da 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 da. Charles.
No, no, no.
I said walks funny.
He walks funny.
What do you say, cutie pie?
I said exactly what Charles said. I said he walks funny.
He walks funny.
He walks funny.
You know, we may have our first scoreless tie. I don't want to say we got a couple of dummies for contestants, but... I don't want to say that, and I'm not going to say that. What do you say?
Well, I wrote what Charles does. Talks funny.
Guard! Give me your deep voice, Charles.
I'm on the Bachelor of the World special.
That's right.
I am.
That's right. I agree. Fanny.
Yes.
Are you participating?
No.
Yes. Yes, you are.
Oh,
she hasn't
yes.
eaten her eggs yet.
What? Do you believe that she is the mother of children?
Yeah.
I said... Tease is funny.
Tease is funny.
Okay.
So, folks,
hey, we're really
it is a new record here, a scoreless tie. Yeah, it's a very distinguished group we have, and that means we got to go to a tiebreaker to break this tie. I mean, this is one of those tight games. Two hot pitchers there. All right, Rolanda, you know what happens here. One question for each of you, and the one who has scored the most, if any, will be the winner. Go, Rolanda, A or B?
B.
B.
B. Yes. Yeah, Rolanda, listen carefully. I enunciate very carefully.
Yes.
Rolanda, you listen carefully. Robinson Crusoe, she's dead. I mean, what are the French know that? You ever hear Robinson Crusoe?
Oh, sure.
Oh, good.
Oh, sure.
Yeah. Robinson
Crusoe. He had a French woman.
That's right. He put this ad in the paper. For sale, cheap. One knife, used only on blank. Robinson Crusoe put this ad in the paper. For sale, cheap. One knife, used only on blank.
Well, that's the silliest thing I've heard.
No, that's a good one. That's a very good question.
That's a beauty.
I like that.
I bet I know what you wrote. I've got it in my head. That's exactly what I thought you would write. Right. We finished down here?
Yeah.
No. Come on, Elaine.
There she is. Okay.
I don't know what he did.
All right. Now, Rolanda. Robinson Crusoe put this ad in the paper. For sale, cheap. One knife. Used only on blank.
Friday.
Friday.
She got it.
She got it. She got the whole idea there. Very good, Roland. Now let's see how many of these dingbats got it. Jack?
I think that's a very cruel answer.
Really?
Yes.
Used on Friday?
Yeah.
Friday, there it is.
So it would tense properly. I put Fridays, but
Fridays.
Actually it's
Fridays. Fridays it is. There's two for you, Rolanda. Charles?
I didn't know what to put, honestly, because I didn't know he killed Friday. I don't know the story.
Well, this was a day
but
of
he
week.
Wrote Friday, she wrote Friday, so what the heck? I wrote Friday, and I bet some people are going to write coconuts.
No one is going to write coconuts, Charles. All right, Elaine.
No.
Somewhere.
You did it.
Before Charles, I'm afraid.
Before you show.
Yes.
I wondered if we could place a small wager, something innocent. I'll give you $1,000 to $1 and you bet me $100.
No.
That means I'll owe you $1,000,000 if coconuts doesn't show up.
Yeah. Could you make it 100 to 1, a penny for a dollar?
Right, okay,
because I think. Go ahead,
Elaine.
Show it to him. Show and tell time.
There should be drums on this.
Ah, yes, drums.
There should be a drum.
Coconuts!
Oh, no. I owe you a penny. Well, that's the last coconut we'll have on this show. What do you say?
Well, because I love the French, so I put Friday.
Naturally.
Vive la France. And vive the coconut.
Speaking of coconuts, Fanny.
Now, yeah. Wait a minute. Caruso, wasn't he the Italian singer?
That was Enrico.
Yeah.
Enrico Caruso was the Italian singer.
Yeah.
This is a hit. This.
He wouldn't have used it on spaghetti, would he?
No.
I'm just playing. Yeah. I wrote Friday.
You wrote Friday. Okay.
Except for a pair of coconuts, you did pretty well with that, Rolanda. And we'll get to your question right after we do a little business with America here and there.
We are in the middle of a tiebreaker. Rolanda's had her question. She scored 5 matches. And now we come to Teresa. You must score 5 to stay in the game. If you have a perfect round, you will win your second game, Teresa. Here we go. The post office worker said, "Hey, here's a package marked glass. Let's blanket." Post office worker said, "Hey, here's a package marked glass. Let's blank it. Let's blank it." All right, she's thinking. And I guess she's got an answer formulated in her head.
I have to make up for the last time.
Break coconuts, honey, and you'll be safe that way.
I'm writing kumquat.
All right. Fanny is... What are you doing,
man? Fanny!
Okay, all right. Now she's all set. Now, Teresa, the post office worker said, "Hey, here's a package marked glass. Let's blank it."
Break it.
What's that?
Break it.
Break it.
She's given an answer that's popular with the audience. She said, "Let's break it." What do you say, Jack Nars?
I say, they said one to the other, "Let's handle it in our usual fashion. Let's smash it or
smash.
Break it."
Break. Okay, there's one match. Break.
Well, as they say in automobile talk, let's break it.
Let's break it. Okay, Charles.
I said also break it.
We need 2 more to tie. Let's see if we do get a tie, or you could win if you go all the way here. What do you say?
I say what they always do.
What?
When you get it, it's broken.
Oh. We may never get another piece of mail through the U.S. Postal Service again.
So what's new?
Well, who wants a good piece of mail?
Yeah.
No letters at all.
What do you got there?
What they always do. They said, "Let's drop it."
Uh-oh, drop it. Got to match Fanny to stay in the game. Oh. Teresa, now we need the roll of drums. Be like 2 fried eggs, stand right on your legs, keep your sunny side up. Okay. Yeah, Fanny, what do you say there?
Well, listen, anyhow, I want to tell you about this. I used to go with the poor little old mailman, and they don't do ugly things like that. They would mark it fragile so it won't break.
Mark it fragile so it won't break. There's the post office, and the winner is Rolanda. Come on down. Congratulations. That's $100 for you. All right, you stand by for a moment here while we say goodbye to Teresa. You'll be leaving here with $600 and our good wishes, Teresa.
Thank you very much.
Nice to have you with us. Teresa Negrete. Hey. Are you ready?
Yes, I am.
Good. Now, you know how this goes?
Yes.
Good. You know, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Bird blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250. And if... Let's have the lights... the lights going on here, $500. Bing. Bing. That's it. $250. Bing. And $100. Bing. Okay, thank you. Gotta do my own sound effects here, then. Now, you're allowed a little help from celebrities. Which ones do you choose?
Richard, please.
You choose Richard.
Bird Brain.
Bird Brain. Okay. Nothing personal, Rolando?
I hope not.
No.
Charles.
Charles.
Oh, wow. Charles. Merci, mon Dieu. I said I have a whole list here. I said birdhouse.
Birdhouse. Birdhouse, he say.
Yes.
She say birdhouse. What do you say? He say.
Do I have another choice?
Well, you have one more.
Fanny, please.
Oh, okay. I think it would be bird bath.
Bird bath. So you have birdhouse.
Yes.
Bird Brain and Bird Bath.
Pick your own.
Or Bird Reynolds.
Oh. Hey, you copied him wrong up on the card there. You got Bird. Nobody said that. Nobody said Bird. Oh. He said Bird.
Bird Brain.
Where do they find those people who make
it's all
out
right,
those
it's in
cards?
My head anyway. Don't worry about it.
Birdhouse is beautiful, the same as a nest, isn't it?
Birdhouse would not match Bird Nest, I don't think. What do you want to choose one of those, Birdhouse, Bird Brain, or Bird Bath, or give us one of your own?
Bird Nest.
You want to choose Bird Nest?
Yes.
All right, you're going to ban the celebrities and go out on your own and choose Bird Nest. And that's the one she's looking for. May we see the $100 response. Birdman, there's one answer. Still looking for Bird Nest. Here's the $250 response. Bird of Paradise. So far, nothing has come up that any of us have thought about. Here's your last chance for Bird Nest. Here is the $500 response. Bird Brain. Richard said it, and no one paid any attention to him. Now, you pay attention to this message, and then you come back, okay? That's a deal. Come back next time for another order of bacon and eggs. Gene Rayburn here for Match Game 74. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of the CBS stations.